All right. What a first round by the Columbus Blue Jackets, sweeping the President's Trophy winners in round number one. Taking a look back at some other notable playoff sweeps. Got to go back to 1986, the last time we had a pretty notable one. It was Chicago, the Leafs sweeping Chicago in that series. You can see 84 happened as well. The Habs over Boston, 3-0. Point differential, look at that, 29. But the point differential in this one from regular season, 30. That's incredible stuff here by Columbus, just getting in down the stretch and taking out the team that had been in probably since the November mark. What do you make here? It's a historic night in Columbus, Weeksy. Of course, Columbus advancing past the first round for the first time ever in their history and knocking out the President's Trophy winners in a first-round sweep for the first time in NHL history as well. What do you take away from this one?
A few different things. Let's start with the fact that this is one of the things about sport. You know, oftentimes you hear people come up to us and, hey, man, my Islanders, hey, my this, hey, my that. Look, sports is a meritocracy. There's no entitlement to sport. And even when you come in as the number one seed, like Tampa, who had a historic season, tying a record for most wins in NHL history with the 95-96 Detroit Red Wings, even they weren't guaranteed to win a series. They had to go out and earn it. And in staying in that point, this is exactly why the Columbus Blue Jackets are moving on. I talked about their mentality. I talked about the belief. I mentioned the fact that I spoke to a bunch of people in their room at Madison Square Garden two weeks ago. As a team, and Nick Foligno, their captain, told me, Weeksy, if we play our style, we know we have a chance. If we play our style, we have a chance. I'll tell you one thing. Outside of the first period in game one, they played their style for every other period for all four games in this series. That's why they're moving on.
Absolutely, and I look forward to seeing them in the next round, and I'm glad they get the rest that they deserve and get to sit back and watch everyone else compete the next couple days.
I got a little twister, though.
What you got?
I got a twister.
What you got?
Everybody, for you guys, KC, you guys are the hunted. You're the number one seed. Team USA, women's hockey, you're the number one seed. How are you able to put all that aside and go out and deliver? Obviously, you guys just won the world, so congrats on that. Olympic gold, too. But how do you guys handle that? Because this is exactly what happened to Tampa. They're the number one seed.
You get everybody's best every single night.
Absolutely. And we were chasing for a while. We had a 20-year medal drought in the Olympic Games for a gold medal. So we knew what it was like to be chasing. And now it finally feels like we're the ones being chased. And it's definitely a different mentality. There's an applied pressure. And I think that applied pressure has to come from within. And I don't think Tampa put that pressure on themselves to be their best every night. And they sat back and relied on their skill and forgot about their effort.
Great points there.
How about Matt Duchene coming away with two more points? He had 7 points in this round number one, and 7 points in just four games. And for everybody saying, well, it didn't fit right after the trade deadline. It didn't fit. It worked when the chips were on the table at this point. Two of the biggest names coming up huge, Panarin and Duchene in round number one. Are you surprised by that?
No, not surprised. I think the biggest thing for Matt Duchene, we were talking about it upstairs off camera, is the fact that he's come into a situation where this is a team that's loaded with talent. He doesn't necessarily have to be the lead thoroughbred, but he's a very, very valuable piece to this team. And by playing a team first game for Matt Duchene, being beneath the puck in the D zone, not rushing, not trying to blow defensive zone assignments, by playing more of a team first game, he was money too. Mm-hmm. And he was able to get that production. And it starts to become infectious. You know, you see your teammates doing a lot of the right things. And for Matt Duchene, this is the most complete game that I've seen him play in this series under the pressure of the Stanley Cup playoffs. In the case of Artemi Panarin, he is an absolute beast. He is. Yeah. You think Patrick Kane gave him a watch earlier this season based on their year as a gift for their seasons together in Chicago just by fluke? Panarin is one of the best players in the league. He's a dynamic game breaker. But we can look at all the individual things. I still think it comes back to the framework of the collective with how well Columbus played as a team.
And I think we go back to Matt Duchene. You think about the last two teams he's been on with Colorado and Ottawa. He's been the face of that organization. He's gone in and had a lot of pressure. He was able to come to Columbus at the trade deadline and just focus on hockey and nothing else and buy into their team as a collective unit. And he definitely has done that, and he's playing that way as well.
How about Sergei Bobrovsky? Because the storyline on him coming in was, yeah, he's great. He's a two-time Vezina Trophy winner, but come playoff time, he doesn't get it done. He doesn't have the save percentage. Guess what? You can throw that notion right out the window, Weeksy. What did you see from Bob in these first four games?
Hey, I saw him 2 weeks ago at dinner, and I could see the look in his eye. I saw that he was dialed in. I saw that he was ready. He's healthy. This is one of the hardest working athletes. I told you guys, long before everybody got on the scene in Columbus, and long before Dubois, and long before Panarin and Zach Werenski and Seth Jones, you had a guy by the name of Sergei Bobrovsky. He's the hardest working guy in that franchise. He really set the compass for this direction that Columbus was going in and to where they are now. And along with that, Jarmo Kekalainen has had some nice additions into this group. And Bobrovsky was excellent in this series. When called upon, I thought he was sensational. He was tremendous. But down the stretch, guys, remember, down the stretch, he took over the lead for most shutouts in the National with 9 down the stretch. And Marc-Andre Fleury was way ahead of the pack.
Way ahead.
So to me, he just continued what he was doing down the stretch in the Stanley Cup playoffs to this point. He's been great.
And he just shut out arguably the best goal-scoring team in the National Hockey League in the regular season in 4 straight games.
Yeah.